فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله، أدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة، وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك، وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن استنى بسنته إلى يوم الدين. وبعد، قال سبحانه: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد، واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون. اللهم ارزقنا الإخلاص في القول والعمل، آمين يا رب العالمين. Respected brothers and sisters in Islam, in last khutbah we were discussing about the journey that we all belong to, the train that is moving. As we were saying, a ticket has three slips. We live in the womb of the mother for 9 months, and when we come to this world, one slip is torn out, and we live for a while in this dunya, and the death, the second slip is torn off, and we are left with one slip, and that will be torn off either in the heaven, in the Jannah of Allah, or in the hellfire. We're talking about this, that hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in which he said, كُنْ فِي الدُّنْيَا كَأَنَّكَ غَرِيبٌ أَوْ عَابِرُ السَّبِيلِ. Be in this world, in this dunya, as a traveler or a stranger. When we go on a vacation, we don't take everything that we have. We only take what is required, what is necessary for that trip. Likewise, Allah says in the Quran, for this traveling of this dunya, وَخَيْرُ الزَّادِ التَّقْوَى. Taqwa is something that is the best of the provision that a Muslim, a true believer, should take with him in the journey that he's moving towards to. The inshallah, in the series of khutbah, we'll be talking about that journey that you and me belong to. What will happen to me and you when we will be about to die? What will happen in the grave? What will happen on the day of judgment? What are the minor and major signs of the day of judgment? So inshallah, we will be trying to, you know, discuss all of that in the series of these khutbah inshallah. And the reason, brothers and sisters, we have to and we should talk about akhirah, the first and foremost reason is it is one of the pillar of iman. Al-Imanu bil-Yawm al-Akhir is part of the belief, is part of our Iman, that we have to believe that we are heading towards a journey of a maut and ba'ath, ba'ad al-maut, and resurrection on the day of judgment, hisab, and inshallah the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the second reason is, brothers and sisters, the reason we have to discuss the tadhkiratul maut, we should remind each other about the death, we should remind each other about the akhirah, is as Aisha radiallahu anha, she said that if the very first thing revealed in the Quran was about drinking, so people would not have stopped drinking. If the very first thing in the Quran was revealed was about not to commit zina, fornication, adultery, the people would have said, we are not going to stop it. But what was the first thing that was revealed in the Quran? A surah al-Mufassil. If you see the surah, the Makki surah, talks about the Tawheed of Allah, talks about the Jannah and the Hellfire. And when the people, they were prepared to receive halal and haram, then in the Madani period, that's what we see, the commands related to halal and haram came. And that's what, you know, we have preparing our iman is the first step when we are preparing for the journey of akhirah. Our iman should be strong, iman bil akhirah, and we should have not iman, but the higher even state is the yaqeen on akhirah. That's why Quran says wa bil akhirati hum not yu'minun wa bil akhirati hum yuqinun. They have yaqeen on the day of judgment, which means there is no raib, there is no doubt about the day of akhirah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam talking about that, he said, لَوْ تَعْلَمُونَ مَا أَعْلَمْ لَضَحِكْتُمْ قَلِيلًا وَلَبَكَيْتُمْ كَثِيرًا. لَوْ تَعْلَمُونَ مَا أَعْلَمْ لَضَحِكْتُمْ قَلِيلًا وَلَبَكَيْتُمْ كَثِيرًا. If you know what I know, you would cry a lot and you will laugh little. You will cry a lot and you will laugh little. A believer, always he has in his mind that one day I am going to leave this dunya. And what is that one day? That can be next moment as well. Every day in our lives we see brothers and sisters, young people, they die. So there is no one too healthy or too young to die. The mouth can reach to us, can approach us, the appointment can come anytime. Al-Maut, as we talked about it, Allah Azza wa Jalla said, "Kullu nafsin dha'iqatul maut." Every soul shall taste death. A Bedouin came to Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. They used to ask this question a lot. Mata sa'a? When is the sa'a? When is the day of judgment? Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam would point out at the youngest among them and say, by the time he reaches his old age, your day of judgment would have already started. Meaning, brothers and sisters, the day of judgment starts with the death. With the death. When a person dies, his day of judgment starts. And soon, inshallah, we will discuss that, how, you know, two kind of people. A person who is a mu'min haqq, a true believer, he has been received by the angels of Allah. And the person who is sinner, who is a disbeliever, how he is received by the angels of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at the time of death. Talking about death, brothers and sisters, there are different stages within that death process. The first and foremost is the ihtidhar, the stage of ihtidhar, which means preparation for the death. Now your soul, my soul, your soul is about to leave the body. That is the stage of ihtidhar. And Allah Azza wa Jalla says, وَيُرْسِلُ عَلَيْكُمْ حَفَظًا حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءَ أَحَدَكُمُ الْمَوْتِ تَوَفَّتْهُ رُسُلُنَا وَهُمْ لَا يُفَرِّطُونَ. When our rusul, our messengers, meaning the angels, they approach them at the time of death, and they never neglect their duty. It's not that they can miss the appointment. If it is Muhammad's time to die, the Muhammad soul will be taken at that time, at that appointment. وَهُمْ لَا يُفَرِّطُونَ. They never, you know, miss the appointment. They never make any mistake in that appointment. وَيُرْسِلُ عَلَيْكُمْ حَفَظًا حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءَ أَحَدَهُمُ الْمَوْتُ تَوَفَّتْهُ رُسُلُنَا وَهُمْ لَا يُفَرِّطُونَ. Now here in the hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned two types of people. Abdul Mu'min and Abdul Kafir. Abdul Mu'min, a true believer, how his soul is being taken by the angels of Allah. What is his protocol? And as this hadith, Rasulullah said, "Inna al-abd al-mu'min, idha kana fi inqita'in min al-dunya wa iqbalin min al-akhirah, nazala ilayhi min al-samaa malaikatan biydhu al-wujuh, ka'anna wujuhahum al-shams, ma'ahum kafn min akfan al-jannah, wa hanutun min hunut al-jannah, hatta yajlisu minhu madd al-basar, thumma yuhyi al-malak al-maut, hatta yajlisu 'inda ra'sihi fa yaqul, ayyatuha an-nafs at-tayyibah, ukhruji ila maghfiratin min Allah wa ridwan." Qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, "Fatakhruju tasilu kama tasilu al-qatratu min qiy as-saqa." Subhanallah. A true believer, when his soul has been taken by the angels descends. And I would like myself and you to just imagine that moment. The person can see those angels now. And if he is a true believer, the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that when a person, a believing soul, is leaving this world and now he is moving to akhirah, he can see those angels coming down. And a true believer, the angels, when they come, they have bidul wujuh. Their face is bright, shining like shams, like sun. They come with the kafan from Jannah, from paradise, and incense from Jannah. And then they come, they descend, and the angel of death sits near that person, and then he says, "Ya ayyatuha an-nafsu at-tayyibah, oh pure soul, come out to the maghfirah, to the forgiveness of Allah and His pleasure." And now the soul of a true believer, Abdul Mu'min, how comes out? How the soul comes out? Rasulullah said, as the drop of water comes out from jug, that's how calmly and smoothly the soul of a mu'minul haqq, a true believer, come out from his body. Subhanallah. And how about the Abdul Kafir? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Inna Abdul Kafir, idha kana fi inqita'in min ad-dunya wa iqbalin min al-akhirah." Then a sinner, a disbeliever, he is now leaving dunya and he is, you know, approaching towards the akhirah. At that time of ihtidhar, he now can see also the angels of Allah descending, but with the black faces. And the kafan is not from Jannah, but the kafan is with the harsh material. And the angel says, "Ya ayyatuha nafsul khabitha, ukhruji ila sakhatin min Allah." O evil soul, come to the wrath and the adab, the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when the angel makes this announcement, the soul inside the body start running around, not trying to leave the body. At this point, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the angel of the death will grab the soul and pull it out as if you are pulling out wet wool from the thorny bushes. How difficult that is. And subhanallah, this will be at the time of death. But now here also Quran gives us the comparison. At the time of death, there is Abdul Mu'min and there is Abdul Kafir. And at this point, look at the protocol of a person who is a believer, who lived his life according to what Allah and His Messenger's commandments were. He, at the end, he made sure that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is radi and happy with us. The protocol from Allah Azza wa Jal starts right at the time of death. Even he did not die at the moment. But here comes the angels of Allah. Comforts him with this beautiful verse that we reminded ourselves many times. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَ اللَّهِ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ أَلَّا تَخَافُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا وَأَبْشِرُوا بِالْجَنَّةِ الَّتِي كُنْتُمْ تُوَعَدُونَ نَحْنُ أَوْلِيَاؤُكُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا مَا تَشْتَهِي أَنفُسُكُمْ وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا مَا تَدَّعُونَ. Imagine for a moment, brothers and sisters, we are in that stage, and here comes the angels of Allah giving us that bishara, that pleasing news, that those who believed on Allah, and it was not, you know, this is what sometimes happens with us. Our level of iman is at a level one day, and the next day again we disbelieve Allah. We are sinner. We commit sin. It should be, there should be an istiqama, there should be a steadfastness in that iman. قَالُوا رَبُّنَ اللَّهُ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا. At the time of death, تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ. The angels will descend upon that person, saying him, giving him that comfort. أَلَّا تَخَافُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا وَأَبْشِرُوا بِالْجَنَّةِ الَّتِي كُنْتُمْ تُوَعَدُونَ. O slave of Allah, you lived a life, maybe there was, you were tested by Allah, but you were sabir in that test. Allah put you in test, but you were radi with the qadr of Allah Azza wa Jal because you believed on this day. Here, abshiru bil jannah. You have the bishara of Jannah, the one that was promised to you. Alladhi kuntum tu'adun. And on the other hand, brothers and sisters, Allah Azza wa Jal talks about the sinners. When their ruh has been taken out by the angels, Allah says, وَلَوْ تَرَى إِذْ يَتَوَفَّى الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا الْمَلَائِكَةُ يَضْرِبُونَ وُجُوهَهُمْ وَأَدْبَارَهُمْ وَذُوقُوا عَذَابَ الْحَرِيقُ. The angels, now look at their protocol. Here, the Abd al-Mu'min is given the protocol that you have the bishara of Jannah. You should not have any fear nor any grief. And on the other hand, right from there, Allah Azza wa Jal says, الْمَلَائِكَةُ يَضْرِبُونَ وُجُوهَهُمْ وَأَدْبَارَهُمْ. Allah's angel, subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah's angel, they start striking them, hitting them on their faces, on their backs. يَضْرِبُونَ وُجُوهَهُمْ وَأَدْبَارَهُمْ وَذُوقُوا عَذَابَ الْحَرِيقِ. Now, Ata ibn Rabah, rahimahullah, he says, a person who talks about the death, who remembers death, gets three kinds of benefit. One is ta'jeel tawbah. He is quick in repentance, coming back and returning back to Allah. If you and me, we are continuously reminding ourselves about the death, the moment we commit sins, what will be the next moment? When we are remembering the death, we will turn back to Allah. We will come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with sincere repentance. Ar-rida bil-qaleel is another benefit, that he is content, he is satisfied with little. He is satisfied with little because he knows that whatever, you know, the materialistic things of this dunya are temporary. I cannot take them in my graves. I have to leave them here. Al-qana'atu bil-qaleel. He's radi with us, with Allah Azza wa Jalla. He's pleased with what he has. And then that he does not fight and compete in worldly manner with anyone. And that gives him comfort. If I ask you and myself, brothers and sisters, most of the time, why I don't have peace, why you don't have peace, if we really ponder over it, we do our self-analysis, in most of the cases, it is because I want more of this dunya. And Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, the son of Adam, if he is given one, you know, a gold full of valley, a valley full of gold, he will ask for another one, he will request for another one. And what will fill his desires? Zurtumul maqabir. The dirt of the grave only can fill the desires that person has related to this dunya. Then after ihtizaz, the hadith of Rasulullah ﷺ mentioned the next stage is sakaratul maut. And Allah says in Surah Qaf, وَجَاءَتْ سَكَرَةُ الْمَوْتِ بِالْحَقِّ ذَٰلِكَ مَا كُنْتَ مِنْهُ تَحِيدٍ. This sakaratul maut, when approaches the person, Allah says, and the stupor of death will come in truth, and that is what you have been avoiding. Me and you don't want to die. And as we mentioned about Abu Dhar al-Ghaffari radiallahu anhu, a man came to him and asked him why people don't want to listen or talk about the Akhirah. He said, because they are not prepared for it. We don't want to die. I want to live long so I can enjoy my life. But how about the life of Akhirah? خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا أَبَدًا. Where we will live forever. Enjoy the life of this dunya. Allah bless you with ni'mah. فَأَمَّا بِنِعْمَةِ رَبِّكَ فَحَدِّثْ. But there should be balance. It should not be at the cost of لَا تُلْهِكُمْ أَمْوَالُكُمْ وَلَا أَوْلَادُكُمْ عَنْ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. Your mal and awlad should not divert you from the remembrance of Allah. وَمَنْ يَفْعَلْ ذَٰلِكَ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْخَاسِرُونَ. It should not be at the cost that, you know, at the time of salah, we are busy in our worldly life and we cannot even pray on time. And so many examples that we can quote. وَجَاءَتْ سَكْرَةُ الْمَوْتِ بِالْحَقِّ ذَٰلِكَ مَا كُنْتَ مِنْهُ تَحِيدٍ. That sakratul maut, even, you know, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he was on his deathbed, he had a pot of water, and he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would dip his hands in the water and would wipe his face and would say, La ilaha illallah, inna lil mawti la sakarat, La ilaha illallah, there is agony, stupor of death. Even Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was feeling it. And where do we, you and me, we stand when that stage will come? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us that istiqama and steadfastness at that time as well, inshallah. And this is the time, brothers and sisters, to remind ourselves that this is the time of tawbah. This is the time when we are taking the breath. We are alive. This is the time when we turn back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Quran says, إِنَّمَا التَّوْبَةُ عَلَى اللَّهِ لِلَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ السُّوءَ بِجَهَالَةٍ ثُمَّ يَتُوبُونَ مِنْ قَرِيبٍ فَأُولَٰئِكَ يَتُوبُ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ وَكَانَ اللَّهُ عَلِيمًا حَكِيمًا. Indeed, the tawbah, repentance, is for a person who commits sin. But he, يَتُوبُونَ مِنْ قَرِيبٍ, he turns back to Allah quickly. And Ibn Kathir rahimahullah, he mentioned, يَتُوبُونَ مِنْ قَرِيبٍ means that before the stage of gharghara, before the stage when a person knows that now khalas, he is about to die, as Fir'aun, he said, حتى إذا أدركه الغرق قال آمنت أنه لا إله إلا الذي آمنت به بنو إسرائيل وأنا من المسلمين. At that time, and he knew that now he doesn't have any option. At that time, he said, I believe on thee, رب of Musa and Harun. But Allah Azza wa said, الآن وقد عصيت قبل وكنت من المفسدين. So يتوبون من قريب is the person, we all commit sins day and night, left and right. But a true believer returns back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with sincere repentance. On other hand, Allah says, وليست التوبة للذين يعملون السيئات. And tawbah will not be accepted from a person that he commits sins left and right, and then when the angel of death approaches that person, حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءَ أَحَدَهُمُ الْمَوْتِ Then he says, قال إني تبت الآن. Now I repent back to you, Allah, but his tawbah will not be accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The time of for tawbah is now, brothers and sisters. As Quran reminds us, أَلَمْ يَأْنِنِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَنْ تَخْشَعَ قُلُوبُهُمْ لِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. Isn't this the time when we should turn back to Allah in the dhikr, through the Quran, through our ibadat? أَلَمْ يَأْنِنِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَنْ تَخْشَعَ قُلُوبُهُمْ لِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. And the battle between us and shaitan will continue, brothers and sisters, until the last moment. As we talked about the stage of ihtidhar, or stage of sakaratul maut. The sakaratul maut is a stage when a person is, you know, is going through consciousness and unconsciousness. He's going back and forth. Abdullah, the son of Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal rahimahullah, he says that my father was on deathbed. And he was going through that sakaratul maut, the stage of consciousness and unconsciousness. And I heard him saying, la ba'd, la ba'd, la ba'd. No, not yet, no, not yet. So he said that, I thought that maybe my father, Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal rahimahullah, he doesn't want to die, that's what he's saying. No, not yet, no, not yet. So he was going through, he said, you know, I went closer to him, so I can ask him if he comes to consciousness again. And when he came into consciousness, I asked him, oh my father, you were saying, la, la ba'd, la ba'd. No, not yet, no, not yet. What was the reason? Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal, the Imam of his time, he said, the shaitan was right next to me and saying that, oh Ahmad, you slipped away from me. Oh Ahmad, you slipped away from me. And I was saying to him, no, not yet, no, not yet, until I die. Shaitan, brothers and sisters, will never give up. Sometime in Salatul Fajr, what happens? We miss Salatul Fajr because we are sleeping. And we blame, of course, Shaitan. He is putting maybe 5 to 10% of the effort for Salatul Fajr, for example, or even when we want to come closer to Allah. That is very, you know, a percentage that is maybe 5 to 10%, you can say. Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, in context of this incident of Imam Ahmad al-Hanbal rahimahullah, he mentioned, he says that the shaitan puts his 100% at the time when a person is leaving this dunya. And sometimes you and me, we think, no, alhamdulillah, I'm strong. I will deal with it. And we are unable to, you know, get up for Salatul Fajr. Because when we want to wake up, we have the waswasa from shaitan. Sleep, that's fine. Sleep. And we listen to that. How about when we are leaving this dunya and the battle that we have with shaitan, how we can defeat him at that time when we cannot defeat him just for Salatul Fajr, for example. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us strength to fight against the shaitan, the battle that we have. The Quran says in the shaitan al-insani aduwwun mubeen, he is our open enemy. That fight will remain until a person dies. So this is the time, brothers and sisters, to return back to Allah and thinking about that journey that we are talking about. Me and you, we all will go through that stage of ihtidhar, that sakaratul maut and the death. Inshallah, we'll continue this discussion in next khutbah also. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to let our last a'mal, our last a'mal or last deed as the best one. Ameen ya rabbal alameen. Aqul qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum fastaghfiruhu innahu al-ghafurur rahim. Alhamdulillah al-wahid al-ahad as-samad الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. قال سبحانه إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم أيد الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم أصلح أحوال المسلمين في كل مكان، اللهم ألف بين قلوبهم وأصلح ذات بينهم واهدهم سبل السلام، وجنبهم الفواحش والفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن. يا مالك الملك، نسألك موجبات رحمتك وعزائم مغفرتك، والغنيمة من كل بر، والسلامة من كل إثم. لا تدع لنا ذنبًا إلا غفرته، ولا همًا إلا فرجته، ولا كربًا إلا نفسته، ولا مبتلًا إلا عافيته، ولا ميتًا إلا رحمته، ولا مريضًا إلا شفيته، ولا مريضًا إلا شفيته، ولا مريضًا إلا شفيته، ولا ميتًا إلا رحمته، ولا دعاءً إلا استجبته. ربنا اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وارحمهم كما ربونا صغارا. اللهم من كان منهم ميتا فأنزل على قبره شهابيب الرحمات، وافصح له في قبره مد بصره، واجمع به في دار كرامتك بغير حساب ولا عذاب. اللهم من كان منهم حيا فأطل في عمره، وأحسن في عمله، واختم له ولنا بخاتمة الإحسان. يا منان ويا ذا الجلال والإكرام، ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين، وجعلنا للمتقين إماما. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم، وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. وأقم الصلاة.